each week on our show, we do what we call farm basics in order to take a concept that we use on the farm or some practice we do on the farm and explain it to non-farmers out there. So whether you're a farmer or a non-farmer, you need to know about spray drift and spray volatility and the difference between the two.
You know, we're in a great spot to talk about this, Brian, because we have two wildly different crops right next to each other on either side of this grass strip that we're standing on. We've got corn on one side, we've got soybeans on the other, and obviously soybeans are a broadleaf crop. Corn is a grass crop. There are completely different herbicides that are going to get used to control weeds in each one, and if some of that grass herbicide drifts over into a grass crop, it could be a real problem.
Okay, so let's define these two terms. Drift is when we're spraying and the spray physically moves because of the wind, most likely, over onto a non-target crop. What volatility is when you spray and the spray lands on the target crop, but then after that it volatilizes, it picks up, it goes up into the air with the vapors, and then it moves over. So the only products that we really worry much with volatility, it's dicamba and it's 2,4-D, or at least the old 2,4-D. The new 2,4-D, called Enlist One or Freelix, we really don't worry about it. We don't have volatility issues. But the old 2,4-D, lots of volatility there. All dicambas, we worry about volatility. So spray drift, as a farmer, we feel like, hey, we can control that pretty well. If the wind is blowing toward the soybeans and I'm spraying corn, I know I can't spray. However, if I'm out spraying in the corn and the wind isn't blowing toward the soybeans, but my spray picks up later and moves after the wind shifts and now it moves over to the soybeans, I feel like as a farmer, I can't control that very well. So we don't like the products that have volatility risk, but again, most products, there is very little to no volatility risk. It's basically only old 2,4-D and any dicamba.
So farmers can manage this a couple different ways. One, they can just choose the right product. Two, they can choose the right day to spray on. And if they say, you know what, it's not windy in the morning, I'm gonna go ahead and spray. The wind's gonna pick up in the afternoon. I'll quit as soon as that wind gets up over 5 miles an hour or gets towards 10 miles an hour. And they can avoid a lot of the problems. The other thing that farmers can do is say, well, you know, it's gonna be kind of borderline for wind. It's gonna be around 10 mile an hour wind. So what I'm gonna do is add something to the spray tank to make those droplets a little bit bigger, a little heavier, so they fall. So they aren't small and fine and can blow easy. Those products are called drift retardants. And farmers have a number of different ones they can choose from depending on which products they're going to be spraying.
When it comes to spray drift, if a farmer has a spray drift issue, and we've had that both directions, we've drifted on somebody and somebody else has drifted on us, those are very often problems where we lose a little bit of yield in a small area of the field or we cause yield loss. That's not good. But with the volatility thing, that can be over a much broader, much bigger area, but usually the yield loss is minimal to none. It's just with dicamba, this has really gotten news here in the last 3 years because of Xtend soybeans, people spraying dicamba later than normal, and a tiny little bit of dicamba volatilizing and moving, and it can cup soybean leaves that aren't tolerant to dicamba. Again, the good news is typically it's not even hurting yield, it's not a big deal, but we don't like it just because it gives all farmers a bad name. So what we encourage people to do to avoid the volatility thing is, again, like Darren said, use the right product, spray on the right day. But the other thing is, if you've got a sensitive crop nearby, make sure the wind is going to be blowing away from the sensitive crop for 2 straight days. That way, all the volatility is going to be done. The wind always was blowing away from that sensitive crop, and you should be in good shape.
Well, spray drift is a big issue, and it's something that farmers have to manage to make sure they don't have problems on their farm. And another thing that they may be out spraying for that they also have to manage is our weed of the week. Can you identify this week's weed?